Photo. It is a weeks away from the beginning of day two of action from the VNL. Good afternoon. Hello. Poland and the USA are warming up. It's crunch day for Poland. They have to win this one. Otherwise, it's all over for them, almost before it's got going. For the USA, it's their first introduction to the finals here in Lille. And a victory for them would guarantee them a place in the semis. Okay, great. Then you want to hear from Mark?
Hello. Oh, yeah. You want me to talk a little bit more? You want to hear my tone? Yeah? It's a wonderful day here in Lille. All the excitement's happening outside.
Yeah, much better for me. Thank you very much. Oh, that's great. Yeah, that's Clayton. Mr. Lebedew and Mr. Lucas, but I'll take Mr. Clayton, that's fine, thank you.
The Grammy Award winning and highest ranking female DJ duo Nervo have partnered as ambassadors of Volleyball with the VNL to produce the Volleyball Anthem. Check out Nervo's live performance right here before the men's gold medal match on Sunday.
Allez, on vous rappelle, mesdames et messieurs, qu'à l'occasion de la finale dimanche, eh bien, n'hésitez pas à venir nous rejoindre très tôt parce que vous aurez l'occasion eh bien, de danser, de vous amuser, de passer un bon moment et surtout d'écouter la musique des toutes nouvelles gagnantes du Grammy Award et bien sûr des premières classées mondiales de demoiselles qui seront donc présentes. Elles s'appellent Nervo. Elles sont partenaires et ambassadeurs du volleyball grâce à l'hymne officiel du volleyball Worlds Collide. Vous le verrez, ce sera donc dimanche avant la finale. On vous attendra donc bien sûr de grosses vitesses.
And also check out the official VNL merchandise shops at gate A, D and F. F like France. Spend 50 euros and get free T-shirt personalization.
On vous le rappelle, mesdames et messieurs, également que les boutiques officielles de la VNL sont ouvertes. N'hésitez pas à vous y rendre pour repartir avec un petit souvenir de cette VNL, les t-shirts officiels. Il y a pas mal de choses, de goodies à vous procurer. Ces boutiques sont situées porte A, comme Autriche.
That's smart. Well, I like it. A like Austria and F like France. Perfect. What can I get there? What can I get there? The official shirt. The fan shirt.
Official shirt. Les t-shirts officiels, donc disponibles porte A, porte D et porte F. Et puis n'oubliez pas que si vous déposez plus de 50 euros, nous vous offrirons un t-shirt personnalisé avec votre nom, avec votre chip préféré, avec ce que vous voulez. N'hésitez pas donc à vous y rendre, porte A, porte D et porte F.
Yeah.
Hey guys, and if you watch our big screen, there is one of the key players of Team USA on it. He's 2.05 meters tall, the outside hitter of Team USA. He's one of the top scorers of the VNL preliminary rounds. He scored more than 110 points so far. Play with number 2 representing the United States of America, it's Aaron Russell.
Allez, vous pouvez le voir à l'écran, mesdames et messieurs, le joueur numéro 2 de cette équipe des États-Unis, qui est tout simplement le deuxième meilleur marqueur des États-Unis, numéro 2 donc, Aaron Russell.
Let's meet another key player of Team USA. Player number 1, 2 meters and 2 tall. He's the best scorer, the best spiker, the best blocker, and the best server so far of Team USA preliminary round, the VNL group stage. Ladies and gentlemen, player number 1, say hello and welcome to Matt Anderson.
Allez, mesdames et messieurs, bien, je vous présente également un des autres joueurs clés de cette équipe des États-Unis, le numéro 1 meilleur attaquant, meilleur bloqueur, meilleur serveur depuis le début de cette VNL. C'est tout simplement le numéro 1, Matt Anderson.
The teams meet for the 37th time in history with the series tied in 1818. And Team Poland, they lost the first match yesterday to Russia in 4 sets. So tonight, it's all or nothing for Poland. Not dropping out of this tournament, you have to win this game. And for Team USA, it's a first appearance here at the VNL Finals. So all the best to both teams. But the Polish tried to get the first win in the second game. with number 9, the tallest player of the Polish league, it's Bartłomiej Lemański.
Allez, vous êtes en train de les présenter tout simplement le grand joueur de cette équipe de Bologne. Il mesure 2m17. Il a, c'est une bonne mesure, 5m12. C'est le numéro 9, il s'appelle Bartłomiej Lemański.
Action, and we will begin with the USA against Poland. Clayton Lucas here with you for this one, and I'm delighted to be joined by Australia head coach Mark Levadue. Mark, fantastic day one action, and now the USA are in the spotlight. With Poland having lost their opening game, it's already crunch time for them.
Yeah, hi Clayton, it's great to be here again this evening. It's exactly right for Poland. It's a win or go home game. They'll be looking to keep their season alive. For the US, they've had a day to enjoy the atmosphere, to have a look around, to see the other teams play. They're going to have a pretty good idea of what they're up against today. And I'm very confident they're going to be ready for a big game.
These were the teams arriving earlier. USA making their way out onto the main court. Coach, a very cool, calm character. This was Poland arriving earlier. They know they have their backs to the wall for this one. But for coach Vital Halen, it seems to be for him, the mantra is getting to use all his players, quite happy to rotate his team, and just see what works best and find solutions as it goes along.
Vital, throughout history as a coach of the German national team, also he was known for players from game to game during the tournament. The 2014 World Championship semi-final, he played as a starting player, Christian Fromm, who had been out of the 12 for part of the tournament. So it's not unusual for him to change guys from day to day. And sneak preview for a little bit later, he's done the same again today.
Russia and stayed on. One of the tallest players just behind Zeski. Lemański at 217, Zeski 218. Two huge middle blockers. This is how things currently look in Pool A. France atop, Brazil second, and it's Russia top, Poland second. Serbia and USA will both be in action today. And for the USA, if they beat Poland, that is it for Poland. They won't be able to go through to the semis. And then come tomorrow, USA play Russia, will be about jostling for position. This was match point. A game between Russia and Poland, and in the end, the Ukraine was who tipped the ball over to put the ball down to give Russia the victory. Perfect start. Poland had got themselves back into the match. They took a set, things were looking good. And then Russia just seems up the tempo. They may have had a block run, four blocks in a row.
The game was pretty evenly poised at that point in the fourth set. Poland had come back up from 2-0-2 to win the third, but Russia just had that little period that broke the back of the game, broke the spirit of the Poles, at least for the day, and that was that. So they got the 3 points, which means that Poland really need not just the win, but probably need to be
And in the head to head, well, it's 18 apiece in terms of the history between the two teams. That is history. They are nations with different players through the ages. Right now, one of the biggest meetings in is all USA. And here are some players to watch.
Great players, both sound in reception and in defence. They're perhaps a little bit less histrionic than some libros that you'll see, but both of them are really good in what they do.
One player to look out for today, Matt Anderson. Interestingly enough, Dan is an opposite player for the USA, plays as an outside hitter for Zenit Kazan in Russia because Maxim Mikhailov is the number one opposite player for them and has played outside for the USA, in fact started as an outside before he was asked to go and play as an opposite, and it may well be called into action as an outside hitter for this one.
Matt is one of those really versatile players. He can do everything. Has no real weaknesses in his game, not the least of which is that he can play two positions at the highest possible level. For the US, they have a real rich vein of talent coming through in receivers with Russell, Jeske, who's sadly injured now, DeFalco coming through, and so it was easier for the US to fit those guys in by slotting him into opposite, and he's done a fantastic job. And in this event, he's gone backwards and forwards between one and the other. The only consistent thing with him is that he's consistently excellent.
We just got a glimpse of Polkanowski for Poland, the middle blocker. Also, he's a rising star within the Polish national team. There's a really good interview with him on the social media of the VNL, where he explains his passion for the game, his love for the game, and his joy of being able to represent his country. No doubt he'll be looking to have that opportunity again. Polish support, as always, magnificent. Wherever they travel in the world, there is plenty of support for Poland. So the players making their way onto court, the flag bearers there will take up their positions. We will have the national anthems for both countries.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you don't stand, please rise for the national anthem of Poland.
Mesdames et messieurs, nous allons à présent passer aux hymnes nationaux. Merci de bien vouloir vous lever. Nous allons commencer par l'hymne national de la Pologne.
national anthem of the United States of America.
Et maintenant, place à l'hymne national des États-Unis d'Amérique.
The national team of the United States of America, the three-time Olympic champions, up to three winning sets to 25 points.
We'll meet the referees in charge.
The referees for this first game today, ladies and gentlemen. The first referee is Mr. Nasser Shaban from Egypt.
Premier arbitre de cette rencontre d'Egypte, c'est Nasser Shaban.
The second referee, Mr. Danny Chespedes from the Dominican Republic.
Second arbitre de République Dominicaine, Danny Chespedes.
Perhaps as these two powerhouses get ready to go at it. So the teams making their way up to Portland start with Holland. We begin with Arthur Shumpert, number seven, going through the outside. Holland shoots the paint to the opposite slots. Number nine, Bartolomei Lemensky, is middle blocking. Start, which suggests he'll be going in the opposite side. Madison plays an inside. Smith, the number two.
Shalbrook, who have been pretty much playing all of their games, some form or another, for Poland, have been their two standout performers. Jizga is nominally their starting center, their best setter is in the lineup for today. Schultz is a guy we haven't seen too much in international volleyball, but he's been a very good player in the league the last couple of years, really strong in block, and perhaps that's why they've chosen him, because the matchup against their position four guys, Sander and Anderson, will be really interesting and perhaps key point on.
Day two of the FIVB Men's Volleyball Nations League is underway here in Lille. And it is the USA in red serving Poland, in white and red receiving. A must-win game for Poland. USA is required for them. They're going to make it through or have any chance to get to the semis. Nice start for them. They have their side out. Confidence booster.
Schultz is straight into the action. He hits it really high and get it short into the court in front of the defense. Smith, it's a really good player. He was already halfway there, and Sharp will give him with a throw, couldn't score it.
Smith now with the serve for the USA. Thinks there was a carry in that rally. Staying in the rally. Chance here now, perhaps, for the USA. Good blocking. Shut it down, Sander.
I think that Schultz maybe is the key guy there in the block. He's forcing it. Well, he actually gets the block. And as I said before, that Sander and Anderson, really key guys for them. Schultz, if he can stop them a little bit, Poland, we're in with a chance. Neither team's really forced to serve at the beginning, which is why we've seen some easy side outs. Are ready for the top spin serve that caused so many problems for Russia yesterday. Polish guys there. play two balls into the block, and on the third swing they could get a faster ball and score. That the Americans had just 30 seconds before.
Definitely a nice. say, I didn't think that he could score it. He was able to find the block. Good cover by Jizga. And they could score it.
Continue with his velocity that he's had to drag this.
coach, the greatest expectations are always his own. The first thing that he's going to be thinking of is what he wants to do with the team. He probably hasn't always managed that in this event. To get to the set, and then he really got disoriented there.
Thank you.
got one more shot at rotation one. That last time, D-Smith was stepping over to the gap with Schultz there. They're setting a ton of big, like we talked about, right? He's over here giving too much space. Area two is on the gap. Middles are going to stay neutral right there, okay? Let's tactically be a little bit better in that rotation. That's a good opportunity. What? Yeah, you're fronting. Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Especially after an error, huh?
Yeah, that's right. That's right. That's right. Okay, here we go.
Let's go, boys.
1, 2, 3. USA.
Thank you.
Dan McDonald on to serve for Patch. Well, Patch's first two serves fairly even hit the green part of the floor, so maybe it was obvious.
Great digging position, 5.
sense too far off the man for him to really have a chance to kill it.
What a great spike that was to finish it off, and a nice celebration.
Sander that opportunity, he took it with both hands.
White making the baseline for a half, but Spiros calling the challenge, he thinks it's in.
He looked to his players to see what they thought of it. He didn't really get a response from them, but he's decided to, at this point of the set, he might as well. Forward, a fair long way onto it, but he's still able to pass the ball.
just toying with the USA as if he was going to play it and step out of the way.
Nice pass from Shelford to get that one. Shorts is in pretty good form right now. That's a relatively easy block out for him. That's because low, he wasn't going for his match.
Certainly the swing hitters for most of the match, for most of the set.
The Poles will be trying to hit the seam between the two receivers that are there, especially when it's the outside spikers, not the libero. They haven't really been able to have much effect on that serve. even though the Americans' placement of the receivers is a little bit deeper than normal. When they're deeper, it's normally easier to hit into the seams, but the Poles haven't been able to get quite enough pressure on that. The Americans, though, serving the ball to position one is at every level is a pretty good forward serve. It's a ball that will then come from behind the setter, and it doesn't matter what the level is. Setters don't like that, and they probably feel that with Jizka, they can predict a little bit better what he's going to do if the ball's coming from behind him.
Sets about to get underway. USA not making any changes. With the serve. USA leading one set to nothing.
Setter a long way there, so it's an indication that they have a pretty good idea of what Jizka is going to be doing.
Thank you.
challenge. Holland lose the point. USA lead by three.
That point. There's another couple of great actions for Zatorski. certainly having a really good game on the Polish side.
Yeah. just done exactly what Schultz has done and then had a little word through the net afterwards.
Actually, I think he's pretty lucky to get a touch on the block on that. The play's the same. The Polish guy was even playing. Except perhaps for a wry smile.
I get it. That one's such a bang-bang play. Get it off the ground. We got good non-setters. We'll just make a play, okay? On. Yep, good. Hey, just keep digging trans. Dig trans. Doing a good job. Here we go.
1, 2, 3.
USA.
I know. Hey, John. Sorry, I missed that first part.
Telling the guys, those digs in transition, keep doing what they're doing. Server when you have the jump serve, when you have such a big lead to go after it, perhaps a little more confidence. Even so, you still see the move from
Hoffman. Talk about it quite often, actually, when it's easy to serve, it's easy to defend, it's easy inside out.
So does that mean the hard part then is to keep that focus, to stay fine in front?
That can be hard. But the point for us is that the biggest pressure you can put on the team is not as much as scoreboard pressure.
That's what the USA are doing right now. Great serving.
Christensen has some really good hybrid there. He can toss you. You can't really tell if he's going to be top spin or float. Receivers are caught in no man's land. Schlipka's not quite into the rhythm of the game. Shanks that into the crowd.
That doesn't help Poland's cause. Some intensity coming in to celebrate that error from the USA. They are a long way behind in the second set.
Had a little sniff when they go back to 10-13. The Americans have been able to extend the lead again. Probably a decisive lead for this set.
Top swing. Good patch this time.
First priority on the serve there was probably to take the pipe out of the play. That's the attack that they fear the most. They're able to do that by making Sander receive. They keep the ball off the net. And it's a little bit heartbreaking there when Patch just comes in and hits it over the top.
Set.
good solution. The angle and the approach took Lemanski out of the block a little bit. Even if the set wasn't great, it was easy to tip that for a point.
Well, at the moment for the USA, it's Poland now. This set will be their last opportunity. It is potentially their last opportunity here to stay in, hoping to go into the semi-finals. They lose this, that's it. They'll have one game to go. Well, they won't have a game to go. This is their second game, but they'll be out. VNL, being the USA, who will go through to the semi-finals with one game to spare.
Holland have started with the same lineup that they started the match with. Pollock back, Jizko Shorts are both back. The US are unchanged too. It's already a better start to the set than they managed in the second. If they get this serve in, they could have some foundation for something here.
Incredible again, that pipe from the USA, so effective.
That's the dilemma with the serve. If you take too much off it, you get the ball to the libero. Libero is, by definition, the best receiver. There are four attackers who can really line up to score the point.
It's an ace serve for Smith. That one won't be coming back.
You can see the frustration on the faces of the Polish guys. It's not really working out for them today. The receiver started a half a step too deep there on the, for the cross-court serve. He really needs to step forward into the angle to be able to receive that one better. To get past.
Chase is on, brilliant from Satorski. Free ball for the USA. Patch dispatches that one with interest. Great rally.
Poland's current situation has nothing to do with the efforts of Zatorski. Played a really good game tonight, but hasn't had a lot of friends on his side of the game. No, their confidence is pretty low at this point. The Americans are just cruising. Dangerous. Similar situation yesterday in the third set between Poland and Russia. Russia won the first two sets reasonably comfortably, but couldn't close out the third. We'll see if Poland have that in them again today.
Got it with a really good put away. Poland able to run their pipe attack.
Be able to get a clean swing at that, like that since the first set.
USA. found the block, and he hasn't found the court either.
Haven't seen Patch do the floats very often. Paid off. Spike error, but paid off. Straight to the outside.
Pushing on the chase, it's not going to come back. That's a wonderful serve. From Sander, we head into the technical timeout. USA leading 8-4 by 2 sets to nothing.
But Sander with the float serve that time. Americans have obviously decided to take a little bit of pressure off the serve, or at least change the pressure. Make the receivers play a few more balls, take advantage of it with, well, block and defense as the previous case, and some service ace maybe on the other.
Sander is having a great game, and he's just brilliant to watch. Such a big leap on him, fast arm, and when he hits that ball, he's almost ramrod straight in the air. So he picks it up as well.
Opportunity.
and that was for Christensen. It's free ball time here for the USA. Smith puts it down through the middle. Extend their lead.
Christensen has been playing with his middle blockers a lot. The set that goes past onto the left shoulder that they can easily hit towards position one. Quite a few times they've been able to
it's not easy playing, and that's something else. But this match, and set, if you push a front bend, you put them up. Your spike is good, you get the ball back, you spike. Don't put balls over. And don't give them aces. In the serve, we need pressure, that's no problem. We need good serves. Yeah, there we need. We need our, from our serve, you have to put the serve. That's the
ball.
At this point, the US have a really good rhythm on their side out. Any time they have a good reception, Christensen's able to make his choices, and all five hitters are in really good form. At this point, he almost couldn't make a bad choice on good reception. It's the first time that for a long time that Jisk has played that ball a long distance to position two or one. He created just enough opening in the block for Bednorsch to make something of it.
One on one by Anderson. That's a sharp look.
Chubbuck ended up a little bit too wide, tried to reach into the seam, but by doing that lost all the form in his block and ends up going off into the stands.
Brilliant serve from Anderson, it's an ace from him, and the USA just keep marching on in this third set, getting further away from Poland.
It's easier to focus on your serve or block when things aren't going very well, but it's nearly always a problem with a side out. And we saw them, again, they're not able to receive the first ball well or at all. And only have a stable side out from service errors. If that's the case, then it really doesn't matter what you do with your serve and block.
Serving run the last time he was back in that position. Shots. Just having a little look back through the net as he goes up to serve as well.
These kinds of tips are tips that you see a lot in the Polish league. Most of the Polish players can use a tip like that.
This one. Schultz unfortunately doesn't get the fingers of the USA block. It's an unforced error from him.
Now they created a good defensive opportunity. It was a pretty good set. I think he just missed his shot.
Time unable to the ball in play. Poland will take the point in what was a rather scrappy rally.
Lomanski and Jizka fell over each other on the first play. Jizka made a decent set from that.
Early call, good leave. We head into the second technical timeout. The USA dominating this third set.
It was a topspin serve that Shelbuck had a lot of success with yesterday against Russia. It's tried it once before. Were able to receive it easily. This time he's had to go for a little bit more because the situation demands some action, but he ended up pushing it too far.
It's all going well. Josh Borges not even got up from his seat. He's not even talking to his players. It's a technical timeout. It's an enforced timeout. He hasn't called it. So the players just getting on some water, talking amongst themselves. The assistant coaches having a little word. It's all pretty cool for the USA right now.
The US team and a few other teams, the assistant coaches will each have a specific role during the course of the game. They'll each be following a different part of the action, and it's normal for them to be giving feedback to individual players or player groups. So you can see, for example, well, we can see the center coach talking with the center. There's one guy following the attack of the opposition, so he'll be talking with the middle blockers.
Serve. It's definitely fine, Poland. Lemanski with a super spike through the middle.
We saw after the first set that the US are serving a lot to position one. They've taken a low wrist serve down there that time. It didn't lead to any block move for them.
With only a couple of steps, didn't have a full run-up for that one, didn't need it.
It's really tough with athletic condition for guys like Anderson and Sander and Russell. Also, when you have a blocker like Jizka, you can take advantage of in those tough situations.
Halt. The block out. Always getting the job done. Belter from Anderson. He has a little look through. Everyone's quite happy to have a little stare at Schultz whenever he's near them.
If you start something, you have to be prepared to finish it. Schultz is a big boy. He won't back down from anybody, whatever the score is.
Christensen there for the USA. Chase from Smith. Great use of the block from Anderson.
It's a really great sequence from the US. The first off the attack ball or the side out ball, they had a really good block again. The transition's not a great set, but Anderson's made a good enough move that he can hit it off the top of the block, which is for him an easy point.
Massive block by Smith. They were waiting for the pipe, and they've shut Poland down.
It's really been quite amazing to see the difference in the efficiency in the pipes in the teams that we've seen in this tournament so far. Every team's struggled with it or hasn't really used it except the Americans. And if they're the best at using it, they're also likely to be the best at defending it, which we saw on that last rally.
Bednar's finding a way through.
Bednoj have made a little bit of a difference in attack since he's come on for Kvalek. He's a little bit taller, he's a little bit more athletic and hit the ball at a high point against the block.
Unfortunately though for Bednoj, that one serve error has cost him his place on court. Kvalek's back off.
Saw it quickly, but Johnson McGaw writing his post-match speech.
Good lead by Poland. Difficult though to see how they're going to get back into this one. USA are dominating across the net. The slippery scene has been excellent.
Really been dominant in every part of the game at the end of the day.
Good covering. Nobody else able to react quickly enough for the USA, and Poland will take the point.
A few times the US haven't been able to be effective in the transition play.
Well, it's got to the point now, it's not a question of if, but when John Spoor and his team take this match and send Poland packing. Smith with the serve. Well, hopefully Sanders okay.
I didn't see exactly what happened there.
I think just like everybody else, all watching that spike and that wonderful dig and not seeing how Sander managed to end up on the floor. He had gone into the net. Maybe he's just winded himself.
What's probably happened is that the middle blocker's flown out and bumped into him when he was in the air.
That certainly happened, but he also, his right knee just looked to Dave Anderson a little bit awkwardly on that right knee as he went down.
Yep, he did. Really unfortunate. He's in great form. It looks like that he knows roughly what it is that he's done, and it looks like it's not good.
Aaron Russell has come in to replace Taylor Sander. It'll be the serve for Poland. Match gets the side out. USA now two away from victory.
Match has had a really good game in opposite position. He's had a couple of tough series with the serve. He's gone to float serving at one point to take his error rate down, but overall he's had a pretty good match.
It's a curse of the commentator, having a good game and then pops that one in the bottom of the net. I won't be too worried by that though. In a really good position here now for the USA to get this one done.
Double sub on Womach and Muzai.
Kvalek has not found the block, he's not found the court. It's now match point for the USA. although it does look like Heyman's going to challenge this. Has he done it in time? He has got the challenge in time. Did it catch the block? We'll find out.
At this point, there's nothing to lose in the challenge. Not that much to gain. Maybe a small bold moral victory to end their season.
Is wobbling around, and it is a touch. Heyman will be delighted with that. Not just yet for the USA. Chuck will be the same. But now, the USA have match point. And that's been the tale of the match, really, for Poland. Too many missed opportunities from the serving line. Haven't put the USA under enough pressure in that department. Now Aaron Russell will go back to serve for the first time in the game. On to replace the injured Taylor Sammon. And the overpass dispatched by Anderson. And the USA have dispatched Poland by 3-0. The USA are through to the semis. Poland will be going home. What a great start for the USA here at the finals of the Volleyball Nations League in Lille.
They came into this match, into this tournament, the finals, as one of the form teams in the competition. They really showed that they are one of the form teams. They brought Sander back, who's had a great game before his injury. They really weren't troubled at any point in the match. Poland will be disappointed more than anything with the performance today. They didn't play the way that they can, certainly the way that they would have planned to. But they have a period to go back home and think about it and replan and get ready for the World Championships, where I'm sure we'll see them at a different level in their development.
One of the goals for the team, Kulkanowski had said in the preliminary rounds, was to make it through to the final six. And when they got here to play to their best, they achieved one of their goals. Individually, some great performances, but as a team, not quite putting it together as they would have liked. If you look at the stats for the match, Poland 4 blocks, USA 5. But in the end, the USA out-attacking Poland.
What you don't see in those stats is the actual attack percentage. After the second set, the Polish team were spiking less than 30% kills against 54 from the Americans. That's not a level that will be successful at this level, and the third set was no different. So it's a tale of the US serve and block and defense against the Polish team, who really struggled to find any rhythm inside out, which put pressure on their serve, pressure on their block, and they weren't able to really take it to the Americans in any area.
That's good to see Poland applauding the fans who have supported them extremely well across the Volleyball Nations League this year. But it is the end of the road for Szalpuk and co. as they head back to Poland. USA it is who will carry on in the tournament. And now we can hear from Mika Christensen.
It looked like an easy job for you playing against Poland, was it or not?
No, it's never easy. You know, these are the best six teams in the VNL, so obviously it's going to be a huge battle. We know Poland's capable of a lot of things, and you know, just a huge credit to how we played today, and I think we're going to continue to improve.
What happened to Taylor Sanders after that crash in front of the net?
Yeah, you know, I don't know, and we're going to do our best to get him out there, and you know, we'll see how he is. We're hoping and praying for the best for him.
Tomorrow it's up to you, winning the group or not against Russia. Do you thought already about the strategy against Russia, or is it now becoming the preparation for the upcoming game?
Yeah, just thinking about it now. You know, we were totally focused on Poland, and I think we did our job very well. And now we're going to focus on Russia and see how that pans out.
All the best.
Thank you.
Great performance from Mika Christensen. Great performance from the team. And the USA will be very happy with their performance. And here are the highlights from the match. Six teams here. Now there are only five. Poland have finished bottom of Pool B and are going home. The USA and Russia now battling it out for top spot. And in Pool A, France with their opening day victory. It now means that coming up later on today, we have Brazil versus Serbia, and Brazil find themselves in the same spot, fighting to stay in the Volleyball Nations League finals. And then coming up after that, we'll have Russia, USA, France, Serbia. All eyes getting firmly fixed on the clash between Serbia and Brazil to come later on. We hope you can join us for that. But for now, though, from all of us here, for myself, Clayton Lucas, and Mark Leberdew, it's the end of the broadcast. Thanks for being part of the game.